Current dear guests, welcome to our Diplomacy of Law Conference, which is organized by Atılım University's Department of International Relations and is served by the students of IAKOS. Today's guest is the Turkish Ambassador of Korean Republic, Honorable Choyunso. Firstly, I will greet him again and express thanks to him. With your permission, I will make a little speech about my experiences that I gained in Korea last year. Çongyeonhanın deham minguk desanimwa, wajushin bungurge kamsadirimyo, dashi insa marsimdirimnida. 그리고 Atılım대학교 국제관계 학과에서 조직하는 Diplomacy of Law에 오신 것을 환영합니다. 저는 Atılım대학교 국제관계 3학년 학생 메이스펙터십니다. 첫 번째로 정경하는 대사님께서 저희 제안을 수락해 주셔서 정말 행복하고 마음으로 감사합니다. 저는 2012년부터 한국에 대한 관심을 갖기 시작했습니다. 최근에 터키에서 한국에 대한 관심이 갖는 사람들이 하루를 많아집니다. 그리고 제 생각하기에 저희 대학교에서도 한국에 관심이 있고 한국어를 배우고 싶은 저와 같은 학생들이 많이 있습니다. 그래서 대상님이 방문과 두 나라 사이 관계에 대한 비판과 본성은 아침 대학교의 학생들에게 매우 중요합니다. 극동아시아 지방 그리고 특히 한국이 국제 관계는 날마다 더욱더 중요해집니다. 하지만 저희 나라에서 아시아 지방의 교환용단 도쿄 제도 찾기는 정말 쉽지 않습니다. 그래서 저도 북동아시아 그리고 특히 한국에 대한 전문가가 되고 미래의 한국과 터키 사이 관계 발전을 위해 도움을 주고 싶습니다. 제가 2013년에 앙카라 대전학당에서 한국어를 배우기 시작했습니다. 그리고 지난 여름에 한국어를 또 많이 알고 싶어서 인하여자대학교 수강도 했습니다. 인생에서 정말로 최고 여름 휴가를 지난해 한국에서 보냈습니다. 그리고 이민금을 사람들과 나누기 위해 기차와 가요는 한국에서 행복한 기억들에 장가에 1등급 했습니다. 저는 한국에서 길을 걸을 때 외국인처럼 느끼지 않았습니다. 그리고 제가 터키 사람인 걸 말하고 나면 사람들이 정말 진철하게 말을 하고 터키에 대해서 많이 물어보고 이야기도 했습니다. 그러나 이 나라와 지역에 관하여 또 배워야 합니다. 그래서 아틀름 대학교를 졸업한 후에 아시아에 관하여 또 공부하고 싶어서 대학원에 가고 싶습니다. 앞으로 한국 덕분에 전문가가 된다고 믿습니다. 전문가가 되기 위해 정말 많이 노력합니다. 제 이야기를 들어주셔서 정말 감사합니다. Dear our guests, first thank you for listening to me. Now I want to mention His Excellency, the Ambassador of the Republic of Korea. Choyunso was born in the 10th of December 1957. He is married and has one son. In 1981, he graduated from the Department of Economics of Sungkyunkwan University. Then he completed his master degrees at Rochester University in 1987. And lastly, he received his doctoral degree at Kyung University in 2013. Cho began his career in 1981 with passing high diplomatic service examination and he attended foreign ministry. Then he became consulate, Korean consulate general in Boston. In 1995, he became first secretary at Korean Embassy in the Republic of Singapore. And he held on his career as first secretary of Korean Embassy in the Russian Federation. In 2001, he was appointed as director for administrative management and legal affairs at Minister of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Affairs and Trade. And in 2003, he became a consular of Korean Embassy in the Federal Republic of Germany. After in 2005, became senior coordinator for planning and management office of planning and management at my Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade. When we came to the last period of honorable Cho Yun-sol's career, in 2013 he became advisor to the Speaker of the National Assembly for Foreign Affairs. Now he has been Ambassador of Republic of Korea in Turkey since 2014. Now I want to deliver the microphone to all honorable guests, the Ambassador of Republic of Korea in Turkey, Cho Yun-sol.
Wonderful chance. Thank you very much, Professor Hassan. And today, I will discuss on the Korean-Turkish relations, past, present, and future, based on my experience as ambassador for the 20 happy years. Mainly, I will discuss on the common features of our two countries, as well as discuss on how to develop our bilateral relations in which field, as well as if time allows, I wanted to do to speak on how to increase against the competitiveness of the student. Before I start my presentations, may I ask you one or two students what comes to your mind first when you think of Korea? May I ask you students, what do you think of Korea? What comes to your mind first?
Culture.
Korean culture? Yeah. All right. How about the other student?
Korean pop.
Korean pop? So, I prepared some questionnaire.
She can speak Korean, by the way.
Oh, what do you think of Korean? I wanted to go to Korea, right? For me, before I come to Turkey, and I always think of the Atatürk, and the other one is called the Turkish soldiers who participate in Korean War. So we really appreciate. But after I arrived here 2.5 years ago, I traveled more than 40 cities, and I enjoyed the visit, and I found great potential of your country. So my impression was different before I came to here. Actually, I always think of the leader, Atatürk, because we learned from our textbook. First, the slide one is the two pictures. It's the exactly downtown of the Korean capital, so in 1950s. And then shady houses near the small rivers. But 50 years later, quite different features, right? Very modern and society. What does it mean? Maybe you can think how rapidly Korea has developed for the last 5 decades. Okay? This one is the graph. You can see how rapidly Korea developed for 5 decades. But I think, for you, these two pictures give us another lesson. What is it? Even a country can be changed within a few decades, right? From the poorest country in the world and the 12th largest economy now. Even a country can be changed. How about yourself? You can, in case you develop your potential, you can change your fate, your future. You can cultivate your future. that's very important, provide us very important lesson for us. So I wanted to give some this idea. The other one is the Korea, where is Korea located? As you see, Korea is in the Asian continent, far east side, but the Turkey, far west side. It's the 8,000 kilometers away between our two countries. But now, many Koreans are visiting. Last year, unfortunately, because of the continuous terrorist attack, the slowdown. But this year, so when I went back last month to Korea, and I took the Turkish Airlines, fully occupied with Korean tourists. And they are coming back to Turkey. Still, major Korean companies are operating in Turkey. 140 Korean big and medium-sized companies are operating. More than 3,000 Korean people are residing living in Turkey. As well as I'm very proud of two Korean Airways. There is the two Korean Airways and the Asian Airways together. Among East Asian countries, there is no other airways to come to Istanbul. No Chinese airlines, no Korean, no Japanese airlines, no Turkish airlines. Only Korean two airlines are coming back to Turkey. I'm thinking the last year, some of the bureaucracy was very concerned, and at that time only 330 passengers in big size flight, and only the 50, but now it's fully occupied. Even on very difficult situations, big Koreans are coming back to your country. So sometimes I ask myself, why Koreans have strong affection and interest to your country? Why? There is some reason, you know? Yeah, that's right. Korean War veterans. We never forget them. You see, now the Korea, North Korea is very similar to Syria. Syria from 1970s, two leaders, the father Assad and son Assad, are ruling for more than almost 50 years. And what happened to Syria? And many citizens are escaping from their countries. Among 22 million citizens, 11 citizens are wandering around inside and outside of the city. Among them, 3 million are wandering as the talk received them. Whenever I drive and I meet them, I feel very sorry. Same thing happened now in North Korea. As you see, now North Korean leaders that ruled from 1945, more than 7 years, three generations, ruled North Korea. Before dividing by South and North Korea, North Korea is more industrialized, more natural resources, but now one of the poorest countries in the world. So there the young generation are escaping, like the Syrian refugees. So we Koreans think, without the sacrifice and devotion of Korean war veterans, your Turkish soldiers, maybe at this moment, South Korean also would have faced same fate like Syrian refugees. So because of the reason, one of each Koreans have in mind, we have very the special feelings of appreciation to your people. Today, as ambassador, on behalf of the Dharma and people of the Republic of Korea, I wanted to deliver once again appreciation, Korean people's appreciation to you. We really great asset. So therefore, every year I host a big event to show our appreciation to your people, to the Korean veterans and family members. In June 6th, we will have a big party in the Korean Park, inviting the Korean veterans. It is the first reason. The second one is that, in my opinion, and then my friend said, you have very time-honored history and multi-layered culture. It's the very attractive element for people to come here. Actually, it's the in the junior, senior high school days in the Korean the history and geography book, this one, the first 12 warriors are walking on the road. We learned in the history book and the geography book. I was quite impressed when I arrived in here and to look at the some rocks with my own eyes. So therefore, even inside of Korea, we wanted to enjoy some time honors in the very historic side. So therefore, we evaluate, appreciate multi-layered history. And then we have the long history of contact. In the year of the 551, in accordance to Korean history book, we have your ancestor, your backbone, and the Korean ancestor have connection together. 105 years ago, we had contact each other. From that time on, the US side moving to west, Koreans also moving east side. And so even though now 8,000 kilometers away, we have no history of connection. The other, the most important factor is the similar feeling and way of life. I was quite surprised to find many similarities between our two people. For example, Proverbs exactly same. 담나야 담나야 별 오루. We have the same. Some the proverb. 내 결산 오는 비철신. We have the exact same. As well as very similar stories. Your people, I know, very friendly, right, to guests. And you provide all the hospitality to foreign guests. When I invited by the Turkish the people, and he prepared lots of dishes rather than spending much money. You treat well the foreign guests or your friend. And then face saving, maybe very similar, this is my observation. I think Turkish are thinking how others are thinking about you, right? And then face saving, as well like Koreans, little hard temper. My observation is right. There's in terms of personality, we have many similarities. And so because of that reason, the way of life and customs are very similar. Turkish are very religious, but moderate, tolerant, and understanding to others, not extremists, like Koreans. We have also our own religion. And Beshtash, you play Beshtash, right? We do, as well as the Gocha, wedding and funeral ceremony. It's very similar. I found many stories we have similar, but we have to understand differences as well. What kind of difference I wanted to say to you? Maybe Turkish are inward, in my observation, inward oriented, because your condition is so good. Korea is a very small country, and then land size 1/8 of your country, in which 75% of land is composed of the rivers and mountains. So because of the very limited arable land, so we have to go abroad. But 100 years ago, Korea is called Homi Kingdom of Korea, which is very isolated kingdom. We are also inward oriented. But nowadays, Koreans are very outward oriented. You can find many Korean businessmen and students in every country. They are very challenged. The other one is the conservative. They put Korea war, but now different. When I invite your guest, Turkish guest, sometimes I was very perplexed when he didn't even touch one food, Korean food. So from next time on, I prepare some bread. Sometimes when I'm looking around, talking about your people, you love the food so much. I love your food as well. Lentil soup and pepte halva, I like very, very much. And but you have taste foreign food as well. And very hesitant to taste the foreign cultures. Food is a kind of culture. Unless you taste the new, the different cultures, you cannot go abroad. You cannot develop yourself. Third one is our decision-making process is quite different from yours. We are Korea also, when I was junior diplomat, either faithfully carry out the orders of my director. But now this is different. Korean decision-making process is bottom-up. So even though somebody raised some issues, I always consult with my junior colleagues. I listen to their opinion. Not anymore from the top-down process. Now Korea is the bottom-up process. So even though we have similarities, there's much difference. We have to understand these differences as well. In case you have the business or contact with Korea, you have to fully understand these differences as well. I want to say it's a changing environment. When I talked in the United States, talked to the president of the World Bank a few years ago, he said this story, world is changing so fast. Maybe most of them you're born after 2000, maybe you didn't experience 20 centuries, but now it's 21st century. Before, the world was governed by G2 or G7 countries. G7 developed economy produced 80% of world GDP, but nowadays they produce only 50%. Without participation, other major countries, developing countries, we cannot solve the global issues like some climate change or the nuclear proliferation or refugee issues or terrorism issues cannot be solved by the Russia and the United States or the China. Imagine the G20, Korea and the Turkey are members. So we are participating in global issues very closely. In the G20 framework, 5 medium-sized countries cooperate more and more. Have you heard of MICTA? Have you heard of MICTA? Now the Turkey is the coordinating countries, but you don't have heard of MICTA. What does MICTA stand for? Do you have any idea? Yes?
Mexico, Indonesia, yeah. Turkey, Australia, and Korea.
Yeah, that's right. 5 medium-sized countries are cooperating very, very closely. This year, Turkey is the coordinating country, and at the end of this month, Turkey will host MICTA speakers meeting in Istanbul for 2 days. Like in the we discuss global and regional issues together. So this world is changing so fast. And catch on, do you know the Industry 4.0? Have you heard of this one, Industry 4.0? In Korea, it's a very, very discussed hot issue now in the world. I will talk about the topic later. But when I first arrived in Turkey, your policy, many people are talking about trade issues, only trade issues. Because that the complaint much about imbalance trade between Korea and Turkey is right. Because as of 2014, Korea exported $6.7 billion of export to Turkey, whereas Turkey exported to Korea $700 million. There is the imbalance, $6 billion in favor of Korea. But when you analyze, look into the component, 60% of them import from Korean side like sophisticated goods or the intermediate goods. We make reprocessing and we export to Europe. It's very good for mutual consideration. Not only the trade issues, we have to think of the other issue, what is the employment, job opportunity, and the technology transfer. And tourism. In this field, many Koreans are coming to your country. So as well, the economy as well between our countries, very, very balanced. But I'm not satisfied. Why? Whenever I travel to your country, I find big potentials. We have to develop more potential. We have to develop more trade, investment, job opportunity, technology transfer, and tourism as well. This is my idea. And we cannot sort everything in a second. And among five elements, what I emphasize to first make is technology. Technology is very important in the coming process. Okay. There's many other projects. Why technology is important? When you look at the Korean development process, and you see, focus on education. Education is very important. You know, because next level. And research and development, Korean research and development portion is 4.3% of GDP. How many percent do you guess in Turkey? Can you guess? How many percent? And you don't? 1.06. Your target to 2023 is 3%. Koreans are number two after Norway in terms of the R&D, the investment. So Turkey has to increase R&D. And it's going to the right direction. But what is more important is the R&D in Korea is propelled by private sector, not government sector. 80% of the R&D is initiated by private companies. Do you know Samsung? LG, Hyundai, Panasonic, and they spend much money. They hire the researchers from every country to develop technology. So I think as well as the private sector entrepreneurship, private sector is very important. So I'm talking whenever I meet you, some businessmen, I ask them to invest in the domestic market. Maybe you can ask foreign companies to come here to invest in your market when your companies invest abroad. I'm asking my companies as well invest inside Korea as well, first. But unfortunately, your environment situation much better than us. Because in Korea, very high labor costs and then many companies coming abroad. Then I'm saying to them, in case you invest abroad, please come to Turkey. First, invest inside Korea, but otherwise, I'm asking them to come to Turkey. Because there is many attractive the elements. Now, last year, this year, the Korean company invested lots of money. And I'm thinking there are more and more Korean companies are coming to Turkey. I will do my best. As well, Korea's trading countries, it means open society. And then good governance means transparent, very, very transparent. We have also some problems. Have we heard some kind of Korean domestic political crisis? Did you hear that? What happened to Korea now? Inside Korea, domestic problems. Ah, yeah. Yeah, transition. You are saying very diplomatically, nice environment. North Korea provocation. Last year, two times some nuclear weapon test, and 24 times missile shooting, this year five times, as well as inside, Korean president unfortunately was impeached. For the last 6 months, there is vacuum in Korean leadership. We have some problems. And then also, we have some tension with our neighboring country, China, Japan, and I'm very sorry. They are very important partners, but we have differences. We have also some problems, high-income threat. In case the Turkey is faced in middle-income threat, but we're facing now high income threats, we have to resolve these problems. But Korea inside Korea, the economic issues, very hard discussions. Now industrial revolution 4.0, that means digitalization and connectivity and smart factory. This new wave is coming to you. And then inside Korea, very hard discussion how to cope with new wave of revolutionary change and then innovation. And Korea is very dynamic by the Bloomberg evaluate the some every country Korea land number one in the field of six classified their sectors. On the one hand, Korea is faced on political crisis and international difficulty, but on the other hand, very dynamic and innovative. Now, the talk is a political, there are many cases, but unfortunately, there is not much discussion on economic issues. Even though there is a post-political issues, there should be more discussion on economic issues as well, how to upgrade your economy. So we focus in development process like this, education, R&D, entrepreneurship, trade, and governance. But still, we faced structural reform from the agriculture society, like in the heavy industry, knowledge-based economy, ICT, information communication and technology. And we are facing new waves. So we are struggling very, very much to operate our economy. But Korea development is mainly based technology into technology-oriented development. You see energy. What is the, when I first arrived in Turkey, Turkey is called energy corridor areas. Have you heard of that word, that term? Energy corridor? That implies Middle East, Central Asia, Russia is the energy the producing country. European country as energy consuming country. And the energy just passing through Turkey without any value addition. And I talk to your people, why energy corridor? Why not energy hub? But now it's different. Your government set the goal of energy. Energy hub means reprocessing, value addition, refinery. So therefore, in order to upgrade your economy, should be trade and technology-oriented development. So therefore, what should we do under this? As I said, we have some common features between our two countries and the very rapidly changing world environment. And what should we do? I think technological cooperation. No countries, no companies are willing to share the technology unless any benefit between two sides. Sometimes some of your businessmen came to me, a group of businessmen came to me and wanted to cooperate in investment. Then I asked them, what do you want from the Korean side? They want financial investment, they wanted high technology, they wanted some human resource training. Then I asked them, then what do you give the Korean side? Maybe after making some product, sell again, because Turkey is a young society. Huge demand, 80 million people. But it's not guaranteed. We have to find mutually agreeable some point. Actually, sometimes the senior official came to me and then to bring in the Korean delegation of IT companies. I asked them why. They wanted to develop more IT sectors. Then I respond to them, why not organize your delegation to send to Korea? Why don't you go to Korea and to look at the factory and the business talk here? This is relevant, inward needs and outward needs. Korea, when we develop our country, we organize our delegation to get more updated information. But it is my observation, in case you need, you request us to come. It's not easy for me. I'm asking many businessmen to come to Turkey. Actually, many business groups are coming to Turkey. But on the other hand, you have to send your delegation to Korea, what some other developed economy, technology. Nobody, maybe the Turkey is very best, very big country, and many, you have to establish, construct a railway. Now import all the trains from European countries. But you cannot continue to import all the trains from Europe countries, you have developed your own brand. For example, Korean Top. Do you know Korean Hyundai? In the 1980s, when the first day produced one, very shabby, low quality. But nowadays, after 20 years later, we developed the Korean Hyundai car is very competitive in terms of quality, in terms of prices. So therefore, as an ambassador, I continue to talk to your people. Technology-oriented cooperation is needed at this moment because Korea is ready, Korean company is ready. Why? We have to show our appreciation in some ways because your grandparents help us. So finally, what is the important to student? Actually, how to enhance your competitiveness. That is my own idea. Have you heard 10,000 hours rule? Like Bill Gates. In case you study every day 3 hours for some subject, maybe 1 month 90 and 1 year 1,000 hours, and 10,000 hours is the 10 years. Without investment, you cannot gain any special. So therefore, it is very famous word in America. In Korea, we have same word, like 10 years even change the shape of mountains. Even a journey of the 1,000 miles starts with small steps. Therefore, 10,000 the hours is very important element to develop, upgrade yourself. How about passion? Passion means concentration. How many hours do you study every day? Including class hours. How many hours?
Four.
Four, five. How about ladies study more?
Ten.
10 hours, including class hours. The other students? Dear ladies, how many hours do you study every day? More than 10 hours? No? I think, in my personal experience, at least you should study more than 12 hours at this moment. In college days, even master's program. In my case, average was 14 hours, I think. Without investment, you cannot upgrade yourself. 10,000 hours and patience means concentration, including class times as well. So investment is very important for your future life. And the other one is the preparedness. In order to get into class, you have to prepare some stuff to raise questions. You have teased your students, your professors. You have raised as many questions as possible and make them difficult. That is the preparedness is very important. As well as the have bold eye means that the bold eye in comparison with bold eye. Like the box means the small insect. So look at the very narrow scope, that you cannot become in the comprehensive perspective in the beginning. But you should be very exact in some information. For example, how many countries are borders with Turkey? How many countries are borders with Turkey? Turkey has how many countries with border? 12. How many countries?
Land borders.
You have to make the. Is it difficult? How many?
Seven.
Is it right? Please stand up. How many, please?
Greece, Bulgaria, Georgia, Syria,
Azerbaijan?
Yes.
And then? Armenia? Seven? Bulgaria? The Greece? Syria? Iraq? Iran? The Georgia? Armenia? Azerbaijan? Eight. What I'm saying, both sides should be exempt. How many cities in Turkey?
81.
18? 81. Now we change it, maybe 78 million.
The refugees increasing.
Ah, yeah. So when you write some papers, it should be very clear and exact. From your ages, what is important is the exact data or chronicles. Otherwise, you cannot become very expert in every field. So you have to, from the start, you should be very exact in writing something. After then, you have to write down your idea, your point, and discuss with your friends. Maybe somebody is liberal, somebody is conservative, but you have your own viewpoint. And in order to start establish your own viewpoint, you have the both side. Later, you will develop the both side, not at this moment. So therefore, this is some element, and you have to specialize, you have to differentiate yourself in order to bring up some comparativeness. In the coming centuries, it's very uncertain, rapidly changing. Unless you have the comparativeness, no company hiring. So you have to develop yourself from now on with keeping in mind of 10,000 hours work or patience and sometimes both sides and preparedness. And the very good idea is the guideline is to read some biography of some successful person in your field. You have to accumulate your potential. That is my personal experience. Sometimes we complain. I complain myself. In case my father was billionaire, maybe the prime minister and the high connectivity. But actually, look at the Ajit Sanjay. Ajit Sanjay. 2 years ago, we had together to encourage young female students to do more studies. Where is he born? Do you know? Where is he born? Martin, very small town. And he's the world's world scholars. We're getting the world prize winners in chemistry. Have you heard of Mr. Ban Ki-moon? He's former UN, the United Nations Secretary General. He was also born, very small village. Experienced the Korean War, and then under very harsh conditions, he upgraded himself. It's up to you, develop your future. And then I wanted to finish my presentation with last phrase. That is, 주냐 뷰리 야파다미시 초. Actually, this phrase, I love this phrase. Because in the 1970s, when Korea was born, a very famous businessman, he said to us, "Junya byeogi apajeogi sicho, you go abroad. Your world is wide. They are waiting for you." Likewise, maybe most Turkish young generation people wanted to stay inside Turkey, but what European countries and Central Asian countries, Middle East countries, they're waiting for you for your coming, and you can be the world leaders. So in the beginning, I said to you, I'm very happy to be with you, the leaders of next generation of Turkey. I wish you great success. Thank you very much.
Perhaps introduce yourself too, please. shortly.
Thank you, Excellency, for your presentation. My name is Andrew Kimmoale, last year student in the Department of International Relations. Originally, I'm from Kenya. I have two questions. The first question is, you've presented to us a very wonderful presentation, particularly on the mutual bilateral relations between Turkey and Korea. My question is, we are all aware of the recent provocation by North Korea, particularly on launching missiles. So how is the level of support offered by Turkey over this issue, now that you know they are very close friends? And the second question touches mainly on the domestic opinion of South Koreans back home. With the recent provocations again, is their daily lives affected in one way or another? Thank you.
Thank you. First of all, welcome to our university. My name is Çağatay and my department is Translation and Interpretation. And my question is, did you manage to harmonize the Turkish traditions?
Thank you.
So once again, harmonize the...
Adopt.
Adopt. And I can respond.
First, these two students are very comparative. As I said last slide, we have to debate. In our case, in the college days, we are not allowed to raise questions because we should be silent in front of professors. But nowadays, young generation is quite different. As you say, even though we have done some differences, there were some questions, you have to raise hand and you make some the questions as many as possible. As for your questions, how to harmonize with Turkish customs, as I said to you, no problem to Koreans. We have same the personality, almost similar personality. We know we experience same political crisis and economic difficulties. So there's absolutely no problem. Even language-wise, Korean and Turkish are some type of language. I was studying the Turkish language in the beginning, but because every weekend I was traveling your country, unfortunately, I didn't continue. But quite easy to learn your language as well. Language, food, and everything is very similar to us, especially way of life, way of thinking, and personality, as I said, very similar. For us, even though 8,000 kilometers away, we are very used to it. There is no problem. And in case of North Korean provocation, we are very concerned, really concerned. And then when I talked to the Korean veterans, they told me with great appreciation, in case something happened, they will come back again to Korea to defend Korea. I really appreciate even their word. At the time in 1950s, Korea was very small, unknown country, and your grandparents, almost 15,000 your parents, your grandfathers came to Korea, and among them, 741 so your young soldiers were killed, and around less than 2,000 were injured and missing. So therefore, yes, I believe Turkish government is very supportive whenever something happened. North Korea tried some nuclear weapons and the program as well, missile shooting, and your government announced some supportive position to Korea. As I said to you, MICTA, some program, G20, we have very close consultation on issues and every issue. We have very close contact with your people. So we appreciate Turkish continuous support. Domestic side, I'm very concerned as well. We Koreans already more than 60 years, we got used to the North Korean provocation. Every year, they did make some provocation. Last year, very serious. But North Koreans are little settled down and continuous provocation got used to. But now it's very serious, and we Koreans understand the serious is. And so now the United States and then China and the Korea is close, have some consultation. But problem, frankly speaking, as I said to you, we have some vacuum of the leadership. So we hope to meet the elect new president in June, the month, in May 9th. After then, we have to cope with North Koreans and the provocation. And then people have to understand this presence of the new the threat by North Korea. And China and the United States fully recognize. And as well as we have some very close consultation with this issue with the countries. Some other questions? Yes, please.
First of all, thank you for your presentation and visiting our university, Mr. Ambassador. And my name is Deniz Khan, and this is my last year. I'm senior student in IR. My question is that does the balance of power principle work for the Northeastern Asia region, or can other countries create countrywide against China to balance its power? Is it possible? Thank
you. You're a senior, right?
Yeah.
How many hours do you study every day?
Less than 12.
Approximately 3 hours.
3 hours. Yeah. You have to increase at least 10. You raise very good questions, balance of power. Like China, Turkey is very similar to Korea. And the Syrian conflict is very similar to the North Korean provocation. Turkey is surrounded by big powers, right? And then influenced by Russia, United States, European countries, as well as the medium-sized Iran, Saudi Arabia, like this. And as well as the non-state actors and sectors like this. PYD was some SPD like this, right? Korea as well as inside Korea as well. Many elements of China, role of China is very important. Now balance of against I don't want to say against China. Maybe we have to cooperate with China, even though there are some differences. For example, Russia. Russia has very different perspective in the issues of Syria, sometimes different with the Turkish perspective as well. We have different perspectives from the missile defense system, but we have to cooperate. We don't want to say the balance of power is it, and we don't want the confrontational gestures. We want to develop. But each country has the first priority of their national interest, any country, China, Korea, and any Turkey as well. So keeping in mind that the national interest, we have to coordinate. We know China push hard for us because they want to keep on their position. But in some respect, we cannot accept. But I don't want to say the balance of power. Even though differences of perspective, we have to coordinate. Rather than rely on the military actions with the diplomatic effort is very important at this moment. So therefore, China is not only for the world politics, for world economy, it's very important. But like between Russia and Turkey, between Russia and the United States, between Turkey and the European Union, and there should be difference. But for diplomats, rather than highlighting the differences, we wanted to find some balanced approach. Reflecting each country's interest.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you for
can I make contact with a Korean university which is in agreement with my university?
Contact point?
Yeah.
She would like to study Korea as a kind of foreign student. Maybe she would
like to continue her career there because she can speak Korean.
I know.
I will introduce my colleagues to get my colleagues your telephone and email. And I will have my director for cultural affairs. He's very specialized. And then I will make some arrangement for consultation for first study in Korea.
That's good. Good news,
what I'm saying is that not for me, for your teachers, for your professors, whenever it's at the end of class, you have to teach me, teach it up with as many patients as possible. As the, he pointed out in balance power, we learned about balance power, we learned about provocations and then how to adapt to different cultures. But what I'm saying is that Koreans are very easily adapt to new situations, new cultures, different cultures. But you have to be, in order to be leaders in the world, in the region, you have to adapt new cultures, new way of life, right? To be challenged. But I think many Turkish people students are very satisfied in current situations. So it's quite different. Koreans is not satisfied. They are not satisfied any time in current situation. They want to upgrade themselves. To some extent, there is a problem as well. Is one or two questions more? Okay.
I just want to, for university, I'm so sorry. I guess you are asking for university. I'm sorry. It's not for a question.
Ask for university?
Yeah, yeah. For postgraduates, I'm sorry.
Program. And okay, it gives us some your email address.
Thank you.
And then, depending on your demand, right? Tailor-made approach. What do you want? Let's find together some appropriate ways to study in Korea.
Thank you for your comment. I'm Benke Beyban and I'm working with Irish University students. My question is, what do you think about the North Korean nuclear program and people strikes?
Welcome to our school and country. I have one question. Did you ever sit on the negotiation table with North Korea?
For your speaking again. I want to ask a question. Minister of Unification, South Korean Minister of Unification said that we don't support the Trump's acting to North Korea. He does not support the intervention of USA, but what will be the response of Korea if there will be an intervention of USA with the leadership of Trump? And what will the reaction of Korea? Does it support the intervention or deliver speech aiming to decrease the tension in the region?
You have very strong interest in North Korean issues, like Syrian issues. I think I found a very similarity in terms of the leadership, the ruling, the governance, and the problem, as well as the refugee issues. As with North Korean spread provocations, very serious. Sometimes we analyze why North Korean regimes continue to make provocation. It's their sole purpose to survive. And then it is said that they saw the case of Libya, and they saw in Iraq, in case they succumb to the pressure from outside, maybe they will they fail and they cannot keep their power. Think about the Syrian Assad regime. Why? They wanted to, the first priority is to keep their regime. It's very similar. In order to make develop to nuclear weapons and the provocations, they wanted to show in case you attack us, we can retaliate. This is a kind of gesture. So we tried from 1993, we tried hard to bring them to negotiating table. They came and they adopted, and then later they rejected some OVID items. They continue to that. In this process, for the last 20 years, they developed high-level missiles. They developed nuclear weapons. We are very concerned. And at this moment, unless there's some give up by the North Korean regime to develop nuclear weapons, the North Korean Peninsula is very serious. As I said to you, the North Korean provocation, the first priority to keep the regime. Like to think of the Syria. When you have questions, always think of them. We are very so used to the Syrian regime, right? Very similar. So therefore, I'm getting some lessons in the Syrian issues to North Korea as well. So provocation is quite closely relevant to keep their regime. And did I have some negotiate with North Korea? Yes, in the Six Party talks, I have been many times in China, and then I saw that how they will deal. And in front, they accept the conditions, but after that, they didn't follow, they didn't keep up the continuous for the last 2 decades. So I'm very serious, and they're very serious about their commitment. And so hopefully that they will change their mind. And then I met North Korean ambassador in Germany and in Moscow as well. They're very excellent, frankly speaking. In the case of developing countries, the quality of they are very competitive. They are talking so well in English and everything, but unfortunately not supported by the region. And sometimes they have to break their promise. I feel very sorry, but I think I met them and they're very excellent. I hope there will be some coming to the table with keeping the promises. Minister of Unification, at this moment, you know, our president, we the government official, and then our president is elected by vote. So when she became the president, she promised to do what to do. Actually, at the beginning, she tried to engage North Korea many, many times for a few years. But unfortunately, North Korea always break their promises. Therefore, at this moment, even the Minister of Unification says that the intervener not to allow the South Korean from visiting to North Korea. But after new election, maybe there's some promise commitment by the candidate. There is different some slogans. And then he is elected as new president. Maybe there should be some change in the policy and in negotiating with North Korea. But it's too early to say at this moment because as the diplomat, I don't want to say some different words from the current administration. Thank you very much.
Offering our guests. So you have basically planted 5 trees in a Balıkesir. Balıkesir Dede Oba Hatıra Ormanı. Pınar Hanım Vitelli Oba.